Hello and welcome to Information Security Governance, Risk and Compliance. My name is Salvador Vaz and today we will learn how to audit Unix operating system. Let's get started. Point number one, general security checks. Make sure that the server is installed in a secure place, environmentally controlled and a lockable area. Check and verify that a system baseline is established for all the critical files, including applications and system directories, and is securely stored and owned by root only. Check and verify that the last login time is displayed while logging in. Ensure all the security patches are installed and a BIOS password has been set and secured. Point number two, make sure that the umask variable is set to 027 or even 077 for better security. Ensure that there is a unique home directory for every user. And check if a server time is configured with a designated network time server. Point number three, make sure that the number of users allowed to log on locally on the server are limited to root, system administrator, or backup operators. Make sure no shell level access is given to any user. Make sure if the user authentication is performed through a password policy, and ensure upon successful logon, a warning message is displayed. Make sure the remote access is provided with a multi-factor authentication, and all the activities of the remote login are logged. And importantly, make sure that the root user or root equivalent is not allowed to log in directly on the end user terminals other than the console. Point number four, make sure that all the system directories and files are owned by root and writable by only root. Make sure that all the powerful commands like kill, kill all, shutdown, init are restricted to the end user. Make sure that the network configuration file /etc/initd.conf is owned and writable by root only. Check and verify that the user and application home directories are set to permission as 710. Also verify that the init file /etc/initab is owned and writable by root only. Point number five, make sure that a VAPT is performed on the server and all the issues are resolved as per the policy. Also make sure that all the commands that begin with R, as in rlogin, rsh or rcp, are replaced with a secure option such as scp. Check and verify that the device files are secured with permission of 600 and are owned and writable by root only. Major system directories like /var/etc/sbin/bin are owned by root or root equivalent only and not writable by users. Point number six, make sure that the files with SUID and SGID is created and is reviewed regularly. Ensure sudo and su logs are created and reviewed regularly. Also check if aliases are created for powerful commands like rm, mv, or cp. Point number seven, make sure that the security settings on /etc/group is such that only root or root equivalent can update the files. Make sure that the permissions for individual profiles is set as 700. And check and verify that no end user is part of the group ID 0, which is a group for root. Point number eight, make sure that the Crontab related activities are logged so that all the jobs running on the system are captured. Make sure that only root or root equivalent has access to cron or cron log files. Point number nine, make sure that a regular backup is performed and ensure that a full system backup is performed whenever there is a change in the system. Ensure that the backup and restoration procedures are defined and copies of these documents are also kept at a DR site. Ensure backups are tested regularly and audit log is configured to track the backup and restoration process. Point number 10, check and verify that system, kernel and application level auditing is configured to track and capture all the critical events. Make sure that the audit files are protected against unauthorized access. And log files and SU logs are secured and reviewed regularly. Thank you for watching. Do provide your feedback, like, share the video. Do subscribe the channel and ring the bell so that you get notification when I make the next video. Thank you.